Take a look at another of the week's talking points, the beginning of Alan Shearer and Blackburn Rovers. And the dream start for Alan continued on Tuesday at Ewood Park against Arsenal, as Clive Tildesley reports.
It always takes time for expensive new signings to find their feet at a new club. Blackburn Rovers' new signings took all of 4 days. Alan Shearer's late winner against Arsenal on Tuesday was his third goal in 2 games and put his team briefly on top of the Premier League. A jackpot return on the summer's biggest gamble.
I chose Blackburn because I had the same sort of feeling when I signed for Southampton at 14 years of age. Sense of smell, really. I feel Blackburn are going places. They're backed up by Jack Walker. Figures that are being quoted in the press are being grossly exaggerated, and I feel it's right to get that point of view over. I could have went, if I wanted to make a killing for money, I could have went abroad because it was offers to go abroad. I didn't feel the time was right to go abroad, and I felt the time was right to come to Blackburn.
But even Shearer was upstaged on Tuesday by a man-of-the-match display from Stuart Ripley. He was Blackburn's previous record buy from Middlesbrough, a comparatively modest £1.3 million.
When I came, I think I was the most expensive player, and it did play on my mind a little bit that people would expect a lot of me. But then, of course, they signed Alan Shearer straight after, which pleased me not only to be playing with him, but to take the pressure off my shoulders a bit, especially as Alan's a goal scorer. People will be expecting a few special things from him, which they've already got, really.
As Ripley, Shearer and co are giving Arsenal the once-over, the man whose money has made them overnight heroes in Blackburn was plotting a move out of the transfer market. Jack Walker's withdrawn a £3 million bid for Geoff Thomas. The Rovers' godfather will pay the top prices, but says he'll no longer go over the top.
Well, everything's over the odds, by the way, before you start. But not double-doubles, you know.
You just won't do it?
No, it doesn't make sense.
I guess you've had this problem in business before, have you, in the steel business?
In a lot of ways, yeah. It's a bit different in steel. You have a chance of getting your money back.
There's a smile on every face at Blackburn Rovers just now. If the Walker millions are putting the star turns under pressure, they're not showing it.
Football's a game you should enjoy, and why should you go out there with feeling the whole world's on your shoulders? You go out in the middle of the pitch and there's 20,000 fans coming to pay money to watch for you. Surely it's got to be a privilege in my mind that people are coming to watch me, not only me but Blackburn Rovers, so it gives me confidence.
I mean, you just see the result against Arsenal. Arsenal, for me, with Leeds, are the top team in the country, and we beat them 1-0, and we just didn't beat them, we beat them convincingly, you know. And I think that's made people sit up and think, well, maybe it's just not a little phenomena, and Blackburn really are here to stay.
A really promising start for Blackburn and particularly the new boys, Gary.
Very much so. It's just what they wanted, isn't it? First time back for quite some time. Two big new signings have both settled in quickly. Things are going for them, aren't they? You look at the goal that they've scored. Alan Shearer's hit 2 from outside the box. How often do they go in? And then he's got a deflection the other night. So things are going for him, and things are going for Ripley, who's impressed me.
Yeah, how much do you know about Stuart Ripley?
Well, I've seen him a bit, and I know one or two lads at Middlesbrough, and they rate him very highly. He's dangerous, he gets crosses in, he's very quick, and whenever I've seen him, he's impressed me.
Yeah, and do you think Blackburn's chances are really bright, or do you think it's just a promising start?
I think it is a promising start. I wouldn't tip them for the league. I think that if they finished in the top half of the table, I'm sure they and Kenny Dalglish in particular would be quite happy. I suppose with the start, their expectations will be higher, but I wouldn't expect too much of them.
Yeah. Well, Blackburn versus Arsenal is one of two Premier League games.